A few bees, Tom.
Ah, it's hard on.
Ah. Father's got some banging blooms this year, haven't they?
Oh, they're lovely, then. Even though I sent me some. The double rate, they are.
Has he got some secret recipe or something that other lads don't know about?
Yeah. Just manure my beds well. Then I treat them with loving care. Like women roses, than ours.
I treat our old lass with loving care. But I don't think she'd take kindly to me manuring bed.
Damn bugger. Hey, tell her what. I can hear a bunch of my red roses for you to take home to your Mavis from me.
Hey, there's not going on between there now, lass, is there?
I wish there bloody were. Unfortunately, that sort of pastime's just a memory to me, worse luck.
Ah, oh, go on, then I'll believe her.
Hey, I'll give her some of the best red ones. She'll like them. They're our old lass's favourite. You take her a bunch home on Sunday, when they were in season, like. Oh. She put them in front of the window. They look right lovely. Take a bunch up to the grave now. Think she knows.
I'm sure she does, Tom.
You're not on fault my day, Horace.
But I have other things on my mind, haven't I?
What, women?
No, wife. We've had a rate slanging match. I'm debating whether to go self-service at garage. If I do, I've got to get rid of one of my attendants. Which one is the problem?
No, my policy is last in, first out.
That's trouble. Last in was the wife's sister.
Don't forget to get your Mavis and them from me, will you?
Thanks a lot. See you, Tom. See you. Okay. See you.
did thank old Tom for me, didn't you, Ron?
Of course I did.
I always feel sorry for old Tom. You know, being on his own like that. When you come to think about it, haven't we got a lot to look forward to, eh? Oh, it scares me to death thought of being on my own when I'm old. Still, I suppose I could always get a dog or something. That's a nice little dog old Mrs. Warren got when her husband died.
Bloody hell.
What's up?
They're going to put a bypass through village to M62, it says here. There's two proposed routes. One through Littlemore Golf Club.
Not if it's you. You don't play golf.
Listen, will you? And other one through Cam's Bottom Allotments. Bloody allotments. They can't do that. Not allotments.
Where are you going?
Down to the pub.
Reckon I could do with a dog now for all company he is.
Never you fear, lads. No bugger's going to touch any of our greens while I'm in charge.
I tell you the count. I see you've read it, then.
Aye.
Bloody allotments, eh? No warning. Just read it in paper like that. I nearly fell off my bleeding chair, me.
Yeah, they can't do it to us.
I tell you they can.
Well, it's evens on, innit? Either the golf course or us.
Well, they've had surveyors in, so both routes will have been approved.
Yeah, I saw them. Blokes with things like cameras.
That's them.
I saw them. I thought they were taking photographs for picture postcards or something. Sneaky buggers, eh? I even posed. I'd have showed them my ass if I'd known.
They're trying it all over the country. Different councils want each other allotments. They want land for buildings, see?
There's more to life than our eyes. Flats and bypasses to motorways, I'm sure.
All them years work gone into them. It's bloody criminal. I mean, first they take your jobs, now they're trying to take your hobbies. I mean, where's it end? I don't know, does that?
I've had my bugger 19 years.
19 years? I've had mine since the Folk War. And when food was scarce during the war, I grew taties, cabbages, you name it, and I grew it. And I give most of it away now. To women with kids whose men were at front fighting.
And war with us, eh? What else did they give away, I wonder? I bet they'll fertilise a few roses and violets in thy time.
They shut their face. They aren't got an allotment, so it's no to do with thee.
And I don't bloody want one, neither.
I'm not sure what final decision rests with council or with Minister of Environment.
Well, it says here, the council will not reach a decision on their recommendation until after the forthcoming elections.
Where do we get a position up?
Oh, I don't know who's going to sign it. There's only 20 allotments. 20 signatures are no good. Anyhow, them jumped up nobody down council offices will take no notice. No, what we want is somebody we influence. Somebody on the inside. A man on council.
What about Horace Burley? He's on council. He might put a word in for us.
He's a member at golf club. He'd be no help to us.
Oh, Burley's up for re-election. He's no force to get in, is he?
That's true.
Yeah, hold on. Why don't one of you put up for council? You don't have to be a member of a party, right?
One of us?
Aye, one of you.
The talk's daft, Tom.
Why do I? Why? You could put up as an independent allotment holder or something. I'll put up myself, but I'm too old. Hey, what about thee putting up, Les?
Me? No.
I should do, you know, it's the duty.
No chance.
Yeah, what about you then, Ron? We shouldn't let them jumped up bureaucrats get away with it, and they will, you know, if we don't do something.
Me? Why me? Why not Sid or Jim? They're out of work. They've nought else to do.
Oh, that'd look grand, that, wouldn't it? Unemployed bloke running for council. Who's going to vote for someone without a job?
Without brains and all.
There's all them that used to be at Steelworks. They'd vote for you.
Most of them's in Costa Brava doing it last redundancy money.
Aye, or playing golf.
Aye. That's up to thee then, Ron.
We have never done out like that before.
I'll bet they said that to your lass on the honeymoon. There's all us a first time for everything. That lads are back, you won't we, lads? What do you say then, Ron?
Well, it's a big decision, isn't it?
Councillor Ron Ollershaw, eh? Sounds double right to me. What do you say, Ron?
That was a party political broadcast on behalf of the Conservative and Unionist Party.
What? I'm pulling up for council. You a councillor? Oh, full other one, he's got bells on.
Mavis, I'm dead bloody serious. I'm pulling up for council. I mean, we thought if one of us could get on council, it'd give us a bit of say as to which route bypass would take.
Why, you wrong. Why not one of others? I mean, Les is brainiest.
I wouldn't say that. Besides, it's not all that's brainiest, is it? I mean, you're top men in government. They're not all those top men with brains and us.
Top persons, you mean, Ron? Not top men?
Ah, there you go. That proves my theory, doesn't it?
Oh, I don't know why you've got to get yourself involved.
If it weren't for men like me willing to get involved and fight for underdog, working classes still be serfs, working for rich and privileged. See, Maeve, there are leaders and followers in this life. Well, I happen to be one of the leaders. And if I'm called upon, like now, it's my duty. I've made my mind up. There's nothing you can say or do will change it. You're either with me or you're not.
Well, you'll have to get a new suit. That brown one's looking shabby. We'll have to decorate and all. I'll get that curtain I've seen on Ponty Market. Whittle up smashing up at my front windows. Mind, if I decorate, colours aren't forced to match, are they? No, I better leave my curtain until after I've picked my wallpaper. I'll go and mash a cuppa. Hey, didn't our Eric borrow me paintbrushes?
It was a foot long, I tell you. I had tape measure on it.
That tells us bloody old.
I could prove if it weren't for our old lass.
Well, what's she going to do with you?
She's bloody at it, ain't she?
What are you buggers on about?
Carrots have grown 1 foot long and they don't believe me.
Hey, you can't prove it because all this is eating the evidence.
That tells some right fisherman's tales, don't you?
Oh, I'm saying them.
Good, I've got some very good news for you. Ron is now official independent candidate for elections. How about that then?
It's great, isn't it?
So it's up to us now to see who gets in.
Well, where is the official candidate then?
He's decorating, isn't he? There, maybe he's stuck a paintbrush in his hand. She's getting house ready for when Lord Mayor comes for a cuppa.
Ron, I've been thinking. We ought to move from here.
Move from here?
Yeah, we could sell this place and put money towards something bigger.
What do you want something bigger for?
Well, something nicer and all.
We've got this place nice. I never thought I'd hear you say you'd move from here. I mean, we've brought all those kids up here. We've lived here all those lives. It's got memories.
Circumstances change, Ron. I mean, when you get on council, well, you've got to face it, love. We'll be moving up in world. We'll have some status. This ain't exactly the place to bring influential people to for a cuppa. We could have a nice house with a garden.
With a garden?
Aye, and a garage to put Rolls Royce in when you get to beat Lord Mayor of Ponty.
It's a great idea, that, Liv.
What, you'll beat Lord Mayor of Ponty? It is. I'll beat First Lady, then.
No, having a garden. I wouldn't need allotment then, would I? So, I wouldn't need to put up for election or out like that, would I? Brilliant idea, that, Maeve. We'll start looking on Monday. Yes, they'll
all come to see me. Look at him off, he's got three. Are you going at mine instead of this?
Well, that's good as one of my own. That's good as one.
Here, Les, what's the procedure now, then?
We're planning an election campaign, don't we? We've got to sell Ron to the public. The only way I know of selling out is to advertise.
Well, that's easy, isn't it? Get your Thomas sandwich board.
You'll get a sandwich if you're not careful, a knuckle sandwich.
Oh, hey, look at that, Tom, I'm trembling.
If we're going to succeed in this election campaign, we've got to raise some cash. It's fairly fast and all.
Simple, that. Put him out of stud. Tom the striker.
What the hell's going on? Is it knockout Tom week or something?
Yeah, we wouldn't have a knockout Tom week, would we?
No. Knockout Tom fortnight.
Think you're clever, don't you? But you're not clever. Clever buggers.
Well then, belt up, this is serious. Then, as I was saying, we need to raise some cash to pay for printing being done. We need leaflets, posters, stickers. We want everybody and the grandma to know Ron O'Shaw's putting up for council.
Well, there, Mavis will see to that without us bothering.
Here, Liz, why don't we organise a raffle? There's plenty of stuff at allotments for prizes. I'd give you some of my best roses.
Hey, hold on a minute. Look, I've got a better idea, mate. Why don't we...
Hang on, with you a minute. Sort it out, yeah.
Pound of beans, please.
Pound of beans? And the old man's had them for his tea, he'll be jumping all night.
Oh, you better give me a pound of runner beans and all then, for me.
Slept in the night, have you?
No, but it might be tonight.
10p to you, 2 bob to anybody else.
Thanks.
Thank you. Bye.
That one'll do, and that one'll do all fine.
20p, please.
Thank you. Oh, you want some money?
Yeah, I'll take it. Thank you very much. Let's have a look. Would
you have a pickle in it, please? Yes, look, 20, please.
Yeah,
we've
got a lot coming up now,
you know. Good,
fine.
Aye,
that's it then, Jim. How's Chelsea once?
Oh, a bit short on carrots, Frank. Manny, make sure all the lads aren't dug any up first.
I thought you were the great carrot expert. I thought, lol.
Get off with it. Has I been spreading it round about my carrots?
I never said a dicky, mate.
Yeah. Have you seen these?
Sack of potatoes, please.
OK.
Oh, and a bunch of those red roses. Oh,
they're all up for you, too.
Go on. See ya. It's paid, ain't he?
Ah, for roses.
And spuds?
He didn't pay me for spuds. I thought it paid you.
Gee, thieving swine.
You know, they keep the money that kind. Never pay any bugger. Hey, I'll bet Rose with his fancy woman. Spuds a bit for wife.
You live and learn, eh? You put that down experience, Tom. Hey, look at this.
How goes it, Ron?
I'm on top of it now, Tom.
Hey, shall I do it bedroom next?
Bedroom? No bloody chance. I've had enough, me.
Oh, brilliant. Brilliant.
We've got to do it like this. Great pop. Well done, our kid.
Yes.
Nice
one,
our
pup.
Yeah.
Them divings.
We're bloody hard of lads, Rum.
I'll say we have. It's a right pity they couldn't have been there.
Mm. We've done what we set out to do. We've made enough cash to pay for printing being done. We've got to decide now on issues.
Well, I want a slogan, don't I?
Yeah.
I thought of something like Ron Allshaw, your working man's candidate.
It's a good one, that.
What about, if you want to save your allotments, vote for Allshaw.
That's no good. The average man in the street's not bothered about allotments. They want to know what you're going to do for them. What we want on our leaflets is what politicians put on theirs. Bullshit.
Oh, that's not right, Les.
But if a ban of allotments are leading the issue, you might as well pack it in now, Ron. For a start, you'll alienate all them that use golf course.
Les is right, Ron. He's wrong, but he's right.
I know I'm right. The leading issue should be something that appeals to everybody, like lower rates, more efficient services, including bus service.
Ah, one bus an hour to Ponte. That's always been a great visit, Richard.
Yeah,
I'm perhaps that right, Les. I'll tell you what I'll do. I've got to go now, but I'll think about it.
Hey, there's no time to think about it. Decision has to be made now. Where are you going anyway?
We promised our lass to be back before she goes to bingo. It's a little job she wants doing, no knows. Look, I'll tell you what I'll do. Out there wants to put on leaflets is all right with me. All right?
He's going to make a bloody good councillor, him, isn't he? He's going to be nipping out in middle of council meeting because our lass wants some coal fetching or something.
It's a nice colour, that. It'll go lovely with my new matching bedspread and curtains.
I'm hungry, me.
I'll go down to the chip shop later. Hey, and that's another thing, Ron.
What's that?
When you get on that council, you want to slap a preservation order on that chip shop.
What the bloody hell for?
To keep it English. Other two in village have been took over by chinky Chinamen. Oh, and I hate Chinese chips.
You can only slap a preservation order on building, not on nationality of bloody chips.
For all this government knows, it could be a red plot. All these chinky Chinamen, they could be just waiting for a signal from Peking to drug out fish and chips and take country of her.
All right, I'll mention it. They'd probably inform MI5 to keep them under surveillance.
What other issues have you decided on, Ron?
None. Left it all to Les. I said out he wants to put on leaflets is all right with me.
Oh, I see. Who's putting up for council, Ron? You or Les?
What do you mean?
Oh, it strikes me you're just his puppet on a string. Yes, Les, no, Les. I'll leave it all up to you, Les.
Listen, Mavis, I can't run a campaign and decorate a house throughout on my own. I'm not a bloody Superman. Get off to bingo, will you, and leave me to it.
I'm not going to bingo.
What?
I'm not going to bingo.
Good garden fruit. I never thought I'd hear that coming from you.
Bingo's gambling. And I've decided, as a future councillor's wife, I should set an example. So I've packed it up.
Bloody hellfire.
That ball came whizzing straight past his righty to the shouts of 4-4. He says, bloody hell, don't tell me there's another three of them coming. Good, didn't it?
You heard that when they were dribbling down me bib.
Yes, still dribbling down your bib.
Nah, dribbles down his tie now.
Hey, up, Boris.
What's up, George?
Did they know that Ron Allershaw's putting up against us in an independent election?
What, Percy Thrower at Taproom?
The same. I've got an order for printing for all his advertising. He's got his mates back in and all.
That's why I've seen him down at council offices. No, he's no chance. They couldn't run a barrow down street, that taproom lot. They're a rate bunch of cabbages.
Cabbages are not, he's putting up.
No, he's no chance. Has he?
Hey, he's got one at allotments down at Cam's Bottom, ain't he?
So he has. Which means that if by some fluke he did get on council, he'd vote to take Rootfoot Bypass through golf course. What do you think, George? Is he a threat?
I don't know, but I think the working men will be impressed with his policies, Horace.
In that case, just to be on the safe side, I think it might be a good idea if you were to suddenly become excessively busy, George. That busy that Ollershaw's printing could take weeks. Get my meaning?
Aye.
And I'll see that you get my order and give it priority, right?
Aye.
What you drinking, George?
Yeah, we've done a good job, haven't we?
Do you think you can tell it's toilet roll?
Nah, of course not.
Buying all these toilet rolls could create a shortage, you know.
I get shops an excuse to put the prices up like they did before.
Mm.
Hey, be hopes we don't get a sudden epidemic of diarrhoea in village.
Chuff sales at Daly's up, won't it?
He nearly dropped bow leg me when Jim said you're on, we're putting up for council. I says, well, good old Ron. It's time we had somebody to put a spoke in for us. Oh, I hope they manage to keep their allotments. It means so much to Jim. And when your aunt got a garden...
It'll be very difficult for Ron to keep his allotment going once he's elected. You know, I mean, workload will be unbearable.
We should probably have to move to a bigger house with an office. I might even have to take typing lessons.
Hey, up, Mavis, look here. Horace Burley's leaflet's just come through our letterbox. I haven't even got mine yet. It's bloody ridiculous time George Harrit's taken with my printing.
Ron, that paint's dripping all over my kitchen floor.
Oh, bloody hell.
Oh, Nick. They're like kids, aren't they? You've got to be behind them constantly.
Hey up, George. What about my printing? I could have done it myself with a ballpoint. Time it's taking thee.
I've been busy, Ron. You know me, debt fair. My policy's first come, first served.
Early bird catches the voter, Ron.
I'd appreciate it if you'd get it done as soon as poss. I can't get on with my campaign without it, see?
All right, see you next week, Ron. Will do.
Cheers. I'll see you then, George.
If he gets on to council, he'll be about as handy as a broken spanner. You know, George, I reckon we're doing the public a service.
Bloody soaked. It's raining cats and dogs out here. I've never known it to come down like this for yonks. Still, it'll do allotments good, though.
Guess what?
What?
Your printing's come.
Oh, great. Where is it?
In room.
Bloody hell, fire.
The silly devils went and left him out. It rained, didn't they? It'll take me at least a week to dry them like this, Ron.
Bloody hell, fire.
Bloody heavy, these buggers. How come they're not carrying any?
Because I've got my punter. We've got to know where we're going, haven't we?
I don't know how me and these fell for this job, do you?
They're as wise as me, dear. I can't remember volunteering.
No, neither can I. I think some other bugger must have volunteered for us.
Aye. Right. You take that side, Sydney. I'll take this.
Right.
Yeah.
Get out of here.
Right. You go that way, and I'll go this way, and we'll meet back here, right?
Right.
No, whoa, hang about a minute. They had shortest route last time.
I should have shortest route every time I'm carrying heavy bag, aren't I?
I'd carry it for thee. It's every man to his own trade, then. I don't want it signals me.
Well, what's that got to do with map reading?
I had to find my way to radio first, didn't I?
They'll worm their way out of out thee. Come on, which way am I going? I want to get a pint tonight.
That way.
All right, where is it?
Is what?
The bag. They had it. I left it on the corner.
They left it on the corner?
Hey, that bag's bloody heavy. Oh, that's it, aren't they?
Hey, I haven't seen it.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. If you left that bag on the corner, some bugger will have pinched it. Oh, bloody leaflets and all.
Christ, see what we're going to do.
With thy fault.
My fault? If they had been in Royal Signals, we might have took turns in carrying the bugger. Les'll kill us.
Well, they won't know we ain't delivered him, will they? Well, not if we keep his mouth shut, that is. I mean, it ain't our fault the world's full of thieving buggers, is it?
Aye. Well?
Well, there's nothing else we can do. We might as well have a bevy.
Right.
Five turn-ups at meeting tonight.
Five?
Bloody five.
Was that counting your mates?
No. We us to a ten.
Well, that's twice as good as five, isn't it, love?
Well, I'm fed up. Now it's going right. I wish I'd never started it all. I'm way out of my depth. I'm just not meant to be a counsellor, am I, Maeve?
Don't ever let me hear you talk in that defeatist way again, Ron Allershaw. You'll make a very good counsellor, one of the best. Don't you think that Harold Wilson, Clement Attlee, Jim Callaghan and the rest of them ever had the moments of doubt? Of course they did.
I'm not exactly in their class, am I?
Everybody has to start at bottom, Ron. Them it's worth the salt anyway. Nobody knows what future holds for them. You could be one at once destined for bigger things. Your mother always said you were different to the rest of your family.
I should bloody hope so. Only lad with eight sisters. I can remember my dad knocking a lot of me, as regular as clockwork, to make sure I didn't turn into a puff.
That's because he cared, Ron. He cared what became of you. Think positive. Say, I'm going to fight and I'm going to win.
I'm going to fight and I'm going to win.
Oh, not like that. Like this. I'm going to fight and I'm going to win.
I'm going to fight and I'm going to win.
That's it. Now you keep saying it while I make you a nice cup of cocoa.
I'm going to fight and I'm going to win. I'm going to fight and I'm going to win.
Am I hell-like? I saw him as plain as I can see thee. He stuck Horace Burley's poster right over top of Ron's poster. Deliberate.
No wonder no booker turned up.
Yeah, the bloody unranded swine.
Ah, well, I thought I'd better tell you, like.
Ah, they did right, Joe, thanks. Hey, Sid.
I'll have a whiskey with you when you're ready.
Aye, when we're ready.
Hey, up, Sid.
What?
There was them leaflets that were pinched.
Aye.
Well, I reckon that would burn his lot and all.
Is it?
Yeah, I do.
I reckon they could be right there, Jim. I never thought about it.
Well, I didn't till just now.
I reckon we owe them buggers one, don't they?
And I reckon we do an arm, mate.
Which way are you going to go first?
There, now. Hang on. Hang on.
You're breaking your finger. You're breaking your finger. Ow! Cut it down. That way. There we are. That's it.
And fingers.
Suppose you know out about that.
Out about what?
That.
Maybe you do, maybe I don't.
Well, I'm betting you do. You're looking for trouble, Allashaw, and you're going to get it.
Oh, I am, am I?
Allashaw.
He's gone barely.
What they are all at about, anyway?
He's flipped his lid. I think me and Sid can answer that one.
Well?
Well, it's like this, see, Ron. Me and Sid's found out that Burley's lot's deliberately trying to sabotage the campaign.
Sabotage?
Sabotage?
That's sabotage.
Sabotage? How? Why?
How? Oh, ask Joe. Why? Because they don't want you on council. On account of your voting to run bypass up golf course. I mean, just think about it. This campaign ain't gone very smooth, has it? I mean, just think about it.
It's true, Ron. It's true as we're sat here.
And this daft bugger couldn't see any further than the end of his bloody conk. I'm having him.
Oh, sit this end down, Ron.
Sit this end down, Ron.
I'll have the swine one way or another. I'll get them. I'll get them all.
Anyway, what's this got to do with Holt?
Detail him, Sid.
Me? Well, you know you said stick a few posters around the village, Les.
Thank you. Would you mind if I put a sticker on your back window?
I'm Horace Burley, your local councillor up for re-election.
Don't talk so loud. My husband's asleep on settee and he works on mornings.
Oh, well, I just wanted to...
Look, I haven't time to talk to you now. Now, if you wake my husband up from his sleep, he's a violent temper. He'll be that mad. Now, you'll have to come back next week when he's on days. Right.
Right, then. We'll go up to... onto Bond Street.
That night?
Yeah, Barnes.
Hey, Ron, I've been thinking. All this silly rivalry. It's a bit childish, don't you think? It's not becoming of men with our intelligence. How about calling it a truce? May the best man win. And just as a show of good faith, 95. It's one of yours. Oh, and Ron. Knock hard, she's a bit deaf.
Why don't you fuck it off? You're a bloody nuisance. I'm bloody... bloody... kill you, you bloody wazzick. Bloody kill you. Bloody...
Still sweating, Ollishaw.
Somebody ought to fill your mouth with quick-drying cement, Burley.
You're on my territory now, Ollishaw. Don't get yourself carried away.
Any more scabby tricks like today and they'd be carrying thee away. On a stretcher. And they can take that as a threat.
It's still early, Burley.
There you are. Out of bounds, aren't you, Horace?
As a matter of fact, Clive, I just popped in to buy the lads drinks and cigars.
These lads?
Aye.
Bloody hell. Did you hear that, lads? Drinks and cigars all round. And Horace Burley's paying.
No need to rush. There's plenty for everybody.
Here. Bloody glad I found you two. Horace Burley's in taproom and it's drinks and cigars all round. It's up to no good, I can tell you.
Counting for votes, eh, Tom?
Well, I won't get mine, though, you know, lads.
Now then, do complete that game. Yeah. Come on, Rom.
Here, hey, where are you going? Here, pub's this way.
How's the wife then, Sam?
Oh, she's all right. But we're wanting a pensioner's flat, you know. And she'll not settle herself till she gets one.
One of my policies, you know, Sam, is more flexibility in the housing system. Dropping of some of these stiffening rules that tend to make folks live where they don't really want to.
Aye, well, it's about time and all.
Well, you tell that good lady of yours to vote for Burley. Oh. Right. I'll have to leave you, lads. I'll see you down at the polling station. Voting for me, I hope. What's the damage then, Clive?
£12.08 for drinks, £2.92 for cigars. That's 15 quid altogether. That must be mad.
Don't worry, Clive. It's all out of expenses. Vote for Burley!
See ya. See ya, lads.
What the hell's going on in here? Harvest Festival?
Ron Ollishaw has been touting. Here, I left you this.
No, do you know where that carrot?
What?
Said they got a carrot foot long.
Is she doing?
Yeah, you can't think if she's eating it.
Maybe you'll have that foot long carrot. Where is it?
Oh, a tool.
What do you like, anyway?
Hard.
Early. Well, of course, you were into the bar, but he came and bought drinks and cigars.
Well, we've done with all the hard work you've put in. And if I don't get me Senant Council tomorrow, I'll eat old Tom's cap.
I'm not buying me another and all.
Can I say something? My husband and I thank you all.
Where have I heard that before?
3 o'clock on a Christmas day.
Hey, speech, Ron, speech.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, or should I say friends? Aye, I should. Friends, I'd like to thank you all for seeing me through this campaign. Even though some of you haven't taken an active part, although you've helped to sell fruit and veg on stalls to raise funds for the cause. And when I get on council tomorrow, I'll do my best for you.
Your lad.
Good lad, Ron.
And I'd also like to say that if that bypass goes through our allotment, they can lay first load of cement or my dead body.
That's the spirit, man. That's the spirit.
Friends, I'd like to point out that Ron's thanked us for what we've done in campaign. But our work's finished now. When Ron gets on council tomorrow, his work will start. So three cheers for Ron. Hip hip!
Hooray! Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Well, I'm not sleep a wink tonight, Ron. I'm too excited.
Get some bevy down here.
You will.
No problem, no problem.
With compliments from the management. And before you jump to any conclusions, Horace Burley's got the same.
Good health, lad. Good health, lad. Get it all, Rob.
What's up, Tom? That looks as though it's end at world.
Just thinking of our old lass, Ron. She won't half enjoy it tonight. She'll hope for her bones up, you know. She's been years up Mother Browning now. Life is all of any path, our old lass.
I tell you what, Tom. Take her some roses up to the grave tomorrow.
Oh, I think I will. Hey, Ron. Doing the best of it, Allotments, for us, won't you? Don't know loads of that and all. If I couldn't take Rose up, Zara, unless she wouldn't half miss him.
I'll not let you down, Tom.
Thanks, Ron. That I bloody couldn't.
Come on, wake up. It's election day. Election day.
Oh,
I brought you a cup of tea.
Well, I feel as though I run into a bloody brick wall.
You practically did, you and Sid. You tripped and fell, pair of you, while doing a Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers.
Who were Fred Astaire?
Sid, you were Ginger Rogers.
Did I make a fool of myself?
Is your headache bad?
I did. Still, it's not under a couple of aspirins won't cure.
Well, come on, get up. We've a vote to cast. And get these new clothes on.
Oh, maybe it's not clothes that make the man. It's what's in here that counts.
Get 'em on.
Ladies and gentlemen, vote now and vote for Burley, your local friendly candidate. A vote for Horace Burley is a vote for a better life. Your local candidate...
Vote for Earlshaw! Don't forget, love, vote for Earlshaw!
Earlshaw is your candidate!
Don't forget, Earlshaw is...
Bring it right back in this kettle. Mavis! Come on! I've been ready for ages, me! Good garden fruit! What are you trying to do, make Queen Mother redundant? Come on, let's get it over with. Ron?
Them two's for us, Ron, lad.
Looks like it.
Don't forget, vote for all the show ladies.
Don't look as though I can go check count, then. I mean, fancy having to have a JP signature to get in. It's bloody ridiculous. And I'm a candidate and all.
It's bloody rubbish, that. I'll tell you what, though, Ron.
What?
I love the whistle. That looks double rating, that. Get this an umbrella and hat, and they're just ready for Westminster.
Don't you start and all. I'm bloody fed up, mate.
So with them complimenting the altar.
Next bugger that says out about this suit, I'll bloody swing for him.
Mrs. Boyle's going to vote for you and Mrs. King's going to vote for you.
How do you know?
Because I told him to.
Good old Maeve. It's Mrs. Warren.
Good morning, Ron. Good morning, Mavis.
Hello.
Good morning,
hello.
Jim. I've come to vote for you, Ron.
Have you? Oh, thanks.
You do look nice, both of you. I thought it were Mrs. Thatcher and Dennis as I walked up.
Come on, Mrs. Warren, I'll walk with you to vote.
Oh, thank you, Mavis. Will you hold me dog while I go in, Ron? Don't want to take him in the polling station. He's not really house-trained yet.
Of course he will. Come on.
You know, Ron, we should have took a leaf out of Americans' book.
What?
Elections, you know, I mean, they do things right, don't they? Balloons, bands, drum majorettes. I was thinking, we should have had our lasses, you know, your Maeve, my Pat, Sid's Eileen, with them right short skirts on and bare midriffs and white boots with feather dusters guinea, knees up, vote for all the show.
Our old lass is all right dressed up like that. She's got a figure like a bag of marbles. Where are you, mucking bugger? Clive.
Which new club are then, Ron?
Eh?
I were looking forward to seeing the new councillors get up.
Has he voted yet?
No, not going to either.
Why not?
Divide the loyalties, innit? I'd be daft, wouldn't I? I've got a business to think about. I mean, I don't have a set of golf clubs. I haven't got an allotment. So I'm abstaining.
I'm voting for thee, then, old Ron.
That better be.
Andy and all these, Ron.
because there's never no paper in bog here.
I hope my missus puts paper in there every morning.
I do when I'll.
Well, there's never none when I want any.
That's only because some bugger's been pinching it.
Does he want a drink, Joe?
Oh, aye, if you're buying, Ron. Whiskey for me.
Give me whiskey, Clive.
97. There you are, sir.
See you, Joe.
Cheers, Ron. I'll be back for that.
Good lad.
With him?
Finished decorating.
Every man's entitled to his own opinion, as long as it's same as mine, that is. What do you know, then, Joe?
Oh, I'm voting for thee, then, Horace.
Having a drink, Joe?
Oh, aye, if you're buying. Whiskey for me, Horace. A double.
A double whiskey for Joe, Clive, please. Did you say you'd voted, then, Joe?
No, I'm going down later.
Because of a bus laid on, you know. It's coming to the pub to take them that's voting for me down to the polling station.
Oh. You're welcome.
Thanks very much. What time?
About 2:30. Oh. You told him door with Burley Rosette on, didn't you, George?
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's all right, then.
Cheers, Horace.
Cheers.
It's a right up. You bloody stupid bird, which is moron.
Who are you calling a moron?
You.
You should have parked it where it could have been seen.
I'm going to park that where it could be seen.
Oh, how is that then?
And they can't.
Oh, give him a cursing.
I've been wanting to put one into that smarmy lol for yonks.
Looks if you shoved a couple of three in there and all.
And I noticed you lot were stood well clear.
There weren't any bugger little enough or old enough for me to have a go at. And it wasn't my bike.
No, it was mine.
It would all get us all into a brawl, would it?
What, bloody Burley's lot? There's not a man among them. I'll tell you what, that Horace Burley better not turn his back on me in a dark alley.
Have you voted yet?
I haven't. It's been rheumatics. They play me up something bloody awful. It's weather, you know.
I shan't be able to make it, Ron. I've done my bloody ankle in.
It looks like we're going to need a couple of bath chairs for your two invalids, doesn't it?
Hey, go and ask Lolly, we'll take Tom and me to polling station in car.
Oh, aye.
Here, Ron. Come on, mate. Come here. Horace Burley's got a bush coming, see?
Lads, for those that haven't voted, have a lift laying on.
Where the hell's it coming from?
Double whiskey. Ron's main.
Somebody order a minibus in here?
Aye, me. Lift up polling station, lads. Keep it quiet.
Alright.
Hey, old Jim, come on with us, buddies.
Yeah.
What are you doing with that? I'm not checking out with us.
Shut up, get it. 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 Shut up, get it.
Bingo.
I thought you'd packed it in.
That's when I mistakenly thought I was going to be a counsellor's wife. I've no example to set now, have I, Ron?
Lads, bypass to M62. It's been axed. Allotments are saved. Didn't you hear what I said? Allotments are saved.
Well, at least golf course is saved.
Hard luck, though, Horace.
Ah, you would have thought a Liberal would get in. Well, you'll have to stand again next year, Horace.
No, I'm retiring from politics. I'm going to improve on my golf instead. Aren't they asking for nominations for a new secretary at golf club? There's quite a few improvements I'd like to make up there. Come on, Clive, drinks for my mates.
So my doses are safe, then.
Ah, they're safe, Tom. We've won after all.
Aye.
Nay, it's better than winning. I won't have to wear that suit, will I?
Come on, lads. Go on.
Divine, shine forth.